Welcome everyone, welcome to Form Next. I'm Luis with Ultimaker and I'm happy that Anne from L'Oreal has joined us. And
hello.
We just wanted to take a few moments to find out a little bit of what you're doing and what your department's doing and what the future for L'Oreal looks like.
Nice to be here with you. Our consumer changed a lot the last 3 years, and they changed more than the last 30 years. They want now everything at any time and anywhere. And that's why we begin a program, a digital transformation program, since 2 years. And on this program, the main priority is to accelerate our time to market. We want to divide it by two. We work on a lot of topics, technology like virtual reality, digital simulation, and the main and the game changer on this planning to avoid the 6 months to develop for our packaging injection mold, it's 3D print like production. And in this waiting, we want to go faster on prototype. That's why we work together to implement fast prototyping in all our area where we have designer in front of all the brands in the group L'Oreal to go from the ideas to the prototype in the day or in 2 days, faster than before.
Excellent, so reducing the turnaround time. So you started to implement these in one center and then spread it throughout, or how did that begin?
We begin by one center. After each team work on new ideas, and some of them push the FDM technology like a new way to prototype, better than some other technology. And to have this accessible, affordable, and local production for prototype on each conception and design center in our office. That gives us more liberty, more agility. And our test and learn phases, when we need to test with consumer, we design, we test. We have local productions, that give more agility and reduce our time to market.
Excellent. So then do you carry that over into other areas now? You manufacturing? I know we saw a positioning jig for labels. Do those designs also influence those?
For plants, the initiative on plants was at the beginning locally, but now we begin a program to have a global deployment of the benefits. So it's two topics, the tools to control the quality of the product. Instead of call a subcontractor, I want this calibration gabarit, this quality and aesthetic, the position of the label of a jar, for example. We can print at home, and it's really quick for the team to begin the production. So now we discover and we share best practice between plants.
Okay.
And this kind of aesthetic control gabarit, it's a first using. And the second one, it's spare part. When we have a new format, packaging format, today the delay can be 15 or it can be 12 weeks to have the new spare part format to snap a cap for the transportation of a jar. With this 3D print at home, we really have a huge benefit on our beginning on trials and production. So that's why now we begin to deploy this program to help all the plants in the L'Oreal group to have the benefit of this technology.
So at the same time you're utilizing the hardware, what are you exploring as far as materials? Are there new materials? Did you start off with standard and grow from there?
We begin by your standard material. We have some needs where we have no solution, so we share with you, for example, when we design new bottle, to have the level of formula we can see through, and we need to fill with our formula. So we need like material clear and with a good airtightness. And you offer the opportunity to develop a new material with fit closer than our needs. And now we have the possibility and we use all our team, use this new material we develop together to validate the shape and the level of our formula on the finished good quicker than before and with new functionality. Before it wasn't possible to fill with our final product.
So now you're doing an end-use functional prototype, functional product, and then you're sharing what you learn with all the engineers at all the different plants?
Yes, and all the engineers of different packaging development team. So this is already deployed the information for packaging team, and for plants, it's the beginning of a best practice sharing.
So that's what I was going to ask you next, is how do you handle training across such a large group and many different centers?
And the key point is to have a leader internally. Okay. After each leader have got a local leader, which is like a coach to help team, like upskilling to discover and which the way of working. So our really digital transformation, we don't put full-time team to do the job. We have like a very short team, like influencer, mm-hmm. coach, and they help all the operational department to upskill them and to understand why we need to change the way of working and really to transform all the company instead of replace to have a global and more worldwide deployment of the program.
Can you share with us how you manage the digital transformation group?
We begin the transformation by a program, a big program, with five key priorities. It's first of all, reduce our time to market to have development more agile, to answer to our consumer more impatient. And second topic, it's to have a connected asset, to have all the data and to be more connected to the needs. The third one is to transform our plants to be more agile, to have the capacity to have many formats on the same line instead of have line very high speed. Afterwards, it's about the data, the supply chain, and all the new frontier of the data with intelligence artificial, and our supply chain will be more agile. And the last one, personalization. Personalization on point of sales, for example, the Teint Particulier with Lancôme. On the point of sale, we have the diagnostic and we produce a formula fit to the color of the consumer.
So you've been a part of the Ultimaker family for some time. Can you talk about the equipment you started with and how it grew and what you hope to do? And
we begin by an Ultimaker 2 Go to explain and share, upskill the team. I buy it at the beginning for a meeting to show and understand on the way that works and the competence of the people we need to manage a printer and the results. Mm-hmm. After that, we decide to open a 3D lab to internalization of the production of the mockup with Ultimaker 3. So we buy 4 Ultimaker 3. We was very happy by the results. And after, we have the opportunity to test the Ultimaker S5. Mm-hmm. And it's really great. The results are very great. We have more choice about material. We have a better reproductibility of the pieces. The size of the plate is bigger, so we can manage more print parts on the same time.
And with the S5, have you taken advantage of using composite materials for any part of L'Oréal?
And now with the Ultimaker S5, we use a high resistance material to fit to the plant using and spare parts to have a better behavior and better resistance.
So now that you're collaborating on hardware and software and materials, what do you see as next? The full adoption, like you say, or what's your dream for L'Oréal? And
Our dream for L'Oréal, it's really mass production with this way, because when a consumer needs something like really a batch of one, it's fit to the needs. Tomorrow, our plant will be completely different than today. It's from the needs. We can have a co-development with our consumer directly for production, like a short circuit and very short decision and a quicker way to answer to the market. And secondly, my dream is to offer new functionality, new beauty experience. Because our CEO explained and shared, we want to move to a beauty tech company. And because and with this technology, we will go through, I am sure, with huge and new experience of the beauty for all our consumers.
Thank you, Anne, for joining us and sharing L'Oréal's vision. We look forward to seeing what you do in the future.
Thanks a lot for this opportunity, Luis, to share the using we have in the group. It was a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you want to find out more about using our products in office environment, please make sure to download the white paper.